Good morning. Melinda Watson here with TVA's Natural Resources. I am here on Osceola Island today for our BioBlitz. Join us this morning as we take you on a tour. I'm going to turn it over to our partners now. Discover Life in America.
Thanks, Melinda. And hi, everyone. I'm Dr. Will Kuhn. I'm Director of Science and Research for Discover Life in America. And I just want to welcome you again to our virtual BioBlitz at Osceola Island. So today we're going to take a walk on some of the beautiful trails here at Osceola, and we're going to look for animals and plants and fungi and see what kind of cool life forms we can find here. And then stick around for the end because we're going to issue you a challenge that you can do here on your own. It's a scavenger hunt, and we'll tell you all about it at the end. So let's go. This beautiful yellow flower is called St. John's wort. Here it's forming this nice little shrub which attracts tiny bees and other insect pollinators. St. John's wort is a common and beautiful plant.
This bird likes to spend time in and around the water of Osceola Island. The great blue heron is the largest heron found in North America. They typically eat small fish or amphibians.
Here's some bee balm called wild bergamot. It's a great insect plant found along the trail here at Osceola. This is in the mint family, have square stems. It's one way to identify them. It's a beautiful little plant. As I said, a great pollinator plant, found a lot of times along wet areas.
This maple tree here is covered in something called lichen. Lichen is these beautiful organisms. Here's one kind. This is another kind. The little stuff that looks like white paint in between the bark here are different kinds. And these are all symbiotic organisms. So it's a kind of fungus that has a symbiotic relationship with algae or bacteria that photosynthesize, so that can make energy from light. These are extremely abundant in humid forest like Osceola Island. If we pan up here, you can see just how much lichen there is on this tree. You can also find it on rocks and on the forest floor. Other tree species, it's everywhere here. Really beautiful.
This species of mushroom is known as a witch's hat. It's part of the waxcat family, so it's pretty slimy. They can be found pretty much anywhere along the Osceola Island Trail, and they're very important because they're a mycorrhizal species that helps provide nutrients to some of the trees around them.
One popular mammal that we commonly see at Osceola Island is the white-tailed deer. Here, we see a doe with two adorable little fawns. White-tailed deer are actually really great swimmers, so this island is a perfect spot for them to live.
We see lots of ferns here on Osceola Island, so it's a great plant to document on iNaturalist. This is a Christmas fern. It's a really common fern all over Tennessee. We see them everywhere here on TVA property. We've also seen some royal ferns, so lots of ferns to document when you're out here doing the scavenger hunt.
While not everyone is a fan of snakes, the black rat snake is nothing to fear. This non-venomous snake is true to its name because it mostly eats rats. Osceola Island is a great habitat for black rat snakes, and they're very common in our region. Black rat snakes are also one of the longest snakes in North America.
These sociable caterpillars will grow into milkweed tussock moths. Like monarch caterpillars, they feed exclusively on milkweed. But unlike monarch caterpillars, they have stinging hairs that defend them from predators. Well, thanks for joining us on this virtual BioBlitz adventure. We hope you really enjoyed that. So now it is your turn. We want to issue a challenge to you. So it's in the form of a scavenger hunt, and it uses the app iNaturalist. So this is an app that you can download to your phone. You'll need to do that beforehand. The signal here is a little spotty. So download an app, and with iNaturalist, you can take photos of animals and plants that you see and upload them as observations, and it'll help you identify them and keep track of what you found. So the challenge is that we have these 12 categories of animals, plants, and other organisms, and we want you to post an observation from one organism from at least 10 of these different categories. And if you do so and fill out a short form on our website, dlia.org, we will send you a cool TVA BioBlitz themed neck buff. Thank you to TVA for sponsoring this event and for hosting it on these beautiful public lands. And thank you, viewers, for tuning in, and we hope you'll join us next time on our next virtual adventure.